Welcome to another episode of Asia Unscripted. Today is Tuesday, June 29th, 2021. I know it's been a while since I gave an update, but it's about time, I suppose. So here in Ho Chi Minh City, the social distancing, aka lockdown, is still technically on. It's kind of confusing what the authorities are expecting of everybody. Non-essential businesses are still closed. Public transportation, including buses and grab cars and taxis, are suspended for now. They do have a group of taxis that will only give people rides to the hospital and back. So there is that. So nothing much has changed, I guess. Cases are still going up. I think last Friday they recorded 600 and something cases in the city, which is a record for the city. The last couple of days it's been about 200 or so, which is still pretty high. They're trying to direct vaccines to Ho Chi Minh City, since this is the where the most cases are going on right now. So we'll see what happens in the next couple of weeks and months. The Thailand Phuket Sandbox. It's supposed to start in 2 days, July 1st. But technically, it's still not official yet. See, in Thailand, when they make laws, national laws, it's not official until it's published in a place called the Royal Gazette. So it hasn't been published there yet. So people haven't been able to get their certificates of entry because technically the sandbox doesn't exist yet. So we'll see how that goes. I think Thailand might be having second thoughts about that. They're having record high cases, and the rules for the sandbox keep changing. And yeah, so we'll see what happens when July 1st hits. But as of this recording, the sandbox hasn't been finally approved yet. It hasn't been published in the Royal Gazette, so we'll see what happens. Bangkok is back on a semi-lockdown status. The dine-in has been eliminated for now, so we'll see what happens in Bangkok, but things aren't looking up for Thailand at the moment. The same could be said for Malaysia. Their lockdown, their full lockdown, has been extended indefinitely, so there's no end date. The Prime Minister wants to get cases down below 4,000 a day before he lifts some of the lockdown stuff. Right now it's about 6,000 a day. So who knows how long Malaysia will stay locked down. A lot of people out of work, a lot of people suffering. Indonesia. They're planning a lockdown as of tomorrow, June 30th. They've had record high cases topping 20,000 a day, which is a new record for them. Details about their lockdown aren't available as of this recording. We're not sure if it's going to be the whole country of Indonesia or just the parts where the cases are high. So stay tuned for that. Let's see. Philippines. They just announced their quarantine statuses for the first part of July. Nothing much changed. Metro Manila is still GCQ with some restrictions. Negros Oriental, where Dumaguete is still under MECQ for at least another 2 weeks. Davao City, CDO, Iloilo, still under MECQ. So that there's a lot of restrictions there. So things, they aren't getting worse in the Philippines, but they aren't improving either. So they just announced today that vaccinated travelers to the Philippines can now quarantine for 7 days. But your vaccination cards have to be authenticated. you know, if from out of the country, they have to be authenticated by some agency in the country, by another agency. So still kind of a pain in the butt, but I guess that's good news, I suppose. Let's see, South Korea, some privileges are coming back, cases are down. Singapore, they reopened dine-in again. I think it is a maximum of 2 people can go dine-in at a restaurant. And if the numbers stay low, they'll increase that to 5 sometime in July. So things are looking up in Singapore. They're already planning for a future that, you know, they'll have cases. They know that, you know, there's never going to be 0 cases of this thing. So they're planning for the future. You know, they're planning that COVID's going to stick around for a while. So hopefully that means they'll start reopening with precautions. Cambodia, Laos, nothing much has changed there. In Thailand, besides the news I gave you, some cases are now spreading out into the province areas, so some schools have been shut down, like in Korat. The schools were just ordered shut down. In the Philippines, schools aren't going to be opening anytime soon. As far as Vietnam, the rumor is tourists have about 1 more month before they got to go. So there's groups on Facebook where many tourists that are here are thinking about heading to Bali, and that might not be such a good idea if they lock down. Heading to Mexico. There's even a Facebook group where the Facebook group has about 700 members. It's just about Vietnamese or expats in Vietnam interested in Mexico. So I think that's going to be a place where many people end up going. So things are definitely still changing. I would still say things are not getting better in Asia. It seems like things are getting better in some places like the U.S., some parts of Europe, but even Australia. I just read an article that half the population is under lockdown again. So 12 million people in Australia under lockdown. So this thing is not close to being over. Stay safe out there, you guys. I'm not sure when I'll do another video again, because the updates aren't coming as fast as I'd like. Anyways, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, hit the notification bell, and you guys just take care out there, okay? This is Jason from Asia Unscripted, and I'll see you next time.